Are we recording now? Yes. Okay. I guess one more day of listening to me babble extra. Although I did get some bad news this morning. Actually, kind of sad. Nancy's voice is much better, and she's able to speak more. So I'm a little distraught. But anyhow, let's see. Drummond Island. We were here with friends, great group of friends. It's amazing the good friends we've made through this through road legal four-wheel drive, through our off-roading clubs. It's been great. Not just four-wheel driving friends, friends. Drummond Island was wet. It was an experience. Did a badge of honor trail. The easiest batch of honor trail I've ever crawled around on. Lots and lots of water. It was wet. It was kind of cool. If people wanted to come back again, I guess I would. With friends. We're fortunate by Shano actually to have Tigerton is really good and some other places to go. But it was a cool experience. Trailhead Campground treated us very well. They even came over and approached us when they saw that we had a bigger camper. Told us a couple other sites that were open where we could have had 50 amp instead of just 30, which if you don't have a camper, it doesn't mean anything to you, but it's kind of cool that they offered that to us. Nice people everywhere on the island, all the jeeping, off-roading people. We had a good meal at Ester's.
Mexican
food, and one of our friends is Hispanic, and she said it was very good, so there's some credibility to that. I guess that's it. We're right now riding on the ferry. No, I'm not tailgating. Our friends Matt and Sarah, they fit their big dually pickup truck with the trailer and their Jeep on it behind us also, so this ferry's very full. You could actually see him in the mirror there. There's his truck. It's kind of a long rig too. I guess that's it. So all in all, Drummond Island is cool. It's a neat experience. Be prepared to be in a lot of water and mud. Say that's it. Friendly, nice people. No complaints about it. And again, I can go. We have to say, you know, and action or something. We can give them those little things that slap down like that.
Okay. Yeah, oh, okay. I'm on it.
Anyhow, I am supposed to mention that we have some videos and some pictures she's going to include with this. And, Pepper was a good dog the whole time.
Well, yeah.
Pretty good. I got nothing else. It was a good weekend. It was good.
We are here at Northern Sun Winery up in Michigan by Escanaba. It's absolutely beautiful. Pulled in about 8 o'clock last night. And of course their little winery was closed over there, that cool little building. Awesome. The owner was very kind, very gracious, and opened up their tasting room for us at 8 o'clock at night, 2 hours after they normally close. It was pretty cool. The dog and I are out here taking a little walk. Check out the vines. Okay, so this are the vines. And they are just loaded with grapes. Just beautiful. But what I've noticed, and what they told us yesterday, is that these are the red grapes, and as you see, they have a netting on them, and they put the netting on the bottom over the grapes, so the birds don't eat all of them. Apparently, they have a large bird population that likes to come through and eat the red grapes before they're picked. But as you see, these vines are loaded. We'll start picking them this Saturday, she said. And I'm kind of sorry, we're going to miss that part because that would be really cool to see. But just the coolest thing ever. I've never been to a winery that you could just walk anywhere you wanted. Here's a good picture of how they're just loaded with grapes. Oh my god. So yeah, they have about 40 acres here. But they only plant about 10, she said. And they produce 12,000 bottles of wine. We got to sample quite a few last night. It was very cool. You can see it just goes for a little bit. Right here by us, this is it. This is what they plant. Kind of cool. Dog likes it. And it was very quiet last night. The stars were amazing. Of course, you can never get a good picture of stars, but... Another little tidbit that the owner told us. They take all the leaves off the bottom, because this is Michigan, and to get as much morning sun and afternoon sun as possible, they take the leaves off the bottoms by the grapes and just leave the top leaves. So that's why you see all the grapes underneath. Look at that. Just incredible. I feel like I should eat something. behind us.
We're just waiting to take a picture of you going through it.
My water bottle!
good now.
Was it fun? Get us wet.